Welcome back to Lambda Test YouTube channel. My name is Marie, and for this short video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to run your Cypress test in headless mode. To follow along in this quick tutorial, there are a few prerequisites that you would need. First, you need to have a terminal or command line with Node installed, ideally the LTS version. You also need to have a code editor such as VSCode and some basic Cypress knowledge. I'll add the download links for Node and VS Code in the video description down below. So if you haven't downloaded Node or VS Code yet, feel free to pause this video and when you're ready, come back and I'll start the quick tutorial. If you followed along on my other Lambda test video about running accessibility audits using Cypress Axe, this code will look familiar to you already. I'll add the link to the accessibility audits video in the description box below if that is of interest. Now, let's get started with the tutorial. I've opened up my terminal as well, and I'm on the root directory of my Cypress project. When you want to launch the Cypress test runner and run your test visually, one of the ways of doing it is to use the command npx cypress open. If you're not familiar yet with npx, npx stands for node package execute. npx was introduced in version 5.2.0 and above of npm, so it's downloaded automatically when you use later versions of npm. npx allows you to execute any package that you want from the npm registry without even installing that package. So let's say, for example, I haven't installed Cypress in this project. I can still use the npx command to run my Cypress tests. Now, in some cases, you want to run your test headlessly or without the need to launch the test runner. To do this, Cypress has a built-in command called run. Using the npx command, I've typed npx cypress run. When you run your test headlessly, you might notice that the test is being run on a browser called Electron. I'll talk a bit more about what Electron is later, but for now, think of it as a different headless browser that is built in. Since we are running our test headlessly, once it's finished, Cypress will automatically generate screenshots if there are test failures, as well as a video recording of the test run so you can debug the test easily. Screenshots and videos can be configured to your liking, but for now, let's keep the default configuration as it is. By default, these are saved in the screenshots and videos folder. Another way of running tests is through adding additional scripts in your package.json file. You can think of the scripts property as a dictionary containing different commands that you can run in your project. It consists of a key-value pair. The key is the name of the command, and the value is the actual command to run at that point. To add a new script to run Cypress test headlessly, let's give it a name of cypress:run for the key, and the command cypress:run for the value. We don't need the npx command here since we have Cypress installed as part of this project. To add another command, we just need to add a new key-value pair by typing it on a new line separated by a comma. Let's add a new command for launching the Cypress test runner. I'll give it a name of cypress:open for the key and the command cypress:open for the value. Now, to run the command, we need to use the npm run command followed by the key itself. So, for example, if you want to launch the Cypress test runner, you have to use npm run cypress:open command. As you can see, running the command launches the Cypress test runner. Let's close the test runner for the meantime. If you want to run the test headlessly, you just have to use npm run cypress run. Now, on top of the additional browsers that you have in your machine, Cypress comes baked in with Electron browser automatically. The Electron browser does not need to be installed separately, so there is that advantage. If you're not too familiar with Electron, just think of it as a framework that is used by developers to create web applications. It combines Node.js and Chromium. The Electron browser is a version of Chromium that comes with the Electron framework. If you also want to run the test on a headed Electron browser so you can debug the test visually, this can easily be achieved by passing in the headed option. Let's run the test, and now you can see that the Electron browser has been launched. Let's add another custom script here, but this time I want to run our test headlessly on a Chrome browser. I'm going to give it a name of cypress:run:chrome and the value of cypress:run --- browser, and the browser name of Chrome. I'm also going to pass in the --- headless option. This option is needed because if not passed, this will launch the Chrome browser instead. Let's go ahead and run the command. And you should see that the tests are running headlessly on Chrome instead of Electron. Depending on what other browsers you have installed locally, you can easily amend the browser name to either Firefox or Edge, for example. To find out what other browser Cypress supports so you have a better idea where to run tests either headlessly or not, check out their guide about launching browsers, which I've also linked in the description box below. And that is pretty much it for this video. I've shown you a couple of ways on how to run your Cypress test headlessly. This is predominantly useful if you need to run your tests on environments where you are not able to launch specific browsers. An example of this is if you need to run your tests on your continuous integration pipelines where you can't launch the Visual Test Runner and interact with your tests as opposed to how you do it locally. If you would like to learn more, make sure to visit LandaTest's blog to read other relevant posts from guest authors, and also check out the LandaTest community if you need to discuss any testing-related questions that you might have or any general queries to other professionals across the globe. Finally, if you're looking at gaining some certifications related to test automation, check out the certifications page from LandaTest. These links will all be provided in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found this short tutorial useful.